In this video, we'll look at how to install MySQL Workbench on Windows system. Let's get started. So first we'll download MySQL Workbench. So for that, let me open my Chrome browser. And here in the search bar, search for MySQL. So once you search for MySQL, in the first search result, you will see this official website of MySQL. So just click on it. So here in this MySQL official website, just scroll down, and at the bottom you will see the link for downloads, and inside that you can see this MySQL Workbench. So just click on it. So once you click on this one, in this download page you can see the support for different operating systems. So I can see support for Windows, Linux, Ubuntu, macOS, all these different operating systems. So let's select Windows, and in Windows by default it provides this exe for 64-bit. In case if you have a 32-bit Windows, so here you have this go to download page. So just click on it. Once you click on this one, in the next page you will see the download file for Windows 32-bit system. So let's go back, and here we're gonna install on 64-bit. So just click on this download, and here it will ask you to log in into Oracle account, or even you can sign up for Oracle account as well, but same time you have option to skip that. So here I have this no thanks to start my download, so just click on it, so which will start the download for me, which will take a while, and will wait till download is completed. So it looks like our download is completed. So let's minimize this, and let's go to download folder. So here you can see this MySQL Workbench exe file. So for installation, just double click on it, and here click on next. So here it is gonna install under C program files, then MySQL Workbench 8.0 CE. So if you want to change the location, so just click on change, and you can give your location, but I will go with the default. So I click on cancel and say next, and here let's go with the complete and click on next and say install. So my installation is started, which will take a while. So it's copying the new files. So our setup is completed. So here in the last page you have this option, launch MySQL Workbench now, so which is checked, so which will launch Workbench for me, and just click on finish. So this is the home page of MySQL Workbench, which says welcome to MySQL Workbench. And here in the connection you can see by default it has created this MySQL 80 connection. Now let's create the new connection. So for new connection, just click on this plus sign, so which will open this wizard. So here let's give the name of this connection. So I say MySQL local, and connection method standard, and host name let's say localhost, and the port one is 3306, which is the default port for MySQL. So in your case, if the port name is changed, so probably you can change here your port number, and here username, let's change the username as well, and default schema, will not put any schema name, and click on this test connection, and let's put the password and say okay. So it says successfully made the MySQL connection, and click on okay. And for saving this connection, click on okay. So here you can see this MySQL local connection is created for me. So for connection, you just double click on it, and which you can connect to your MySQL. Now let's explore some other options. So just click on file and you go to new model. So here you can create the data model or physical model for your MySQL database. So here you can add your table, views, routines, all this, the database object, and which will create this and the physical diagram for your MySQL database. Now this is about this MySQL model. Now let's go back to home page and let's go to scripting. So here you have the scripting cell, and just click on new script. So here you can see this the Python script. So let's go with this Python script. Now here let's give the script name. So I say sample.py and say create. So here I can see this one. Let me maximize this. And here let's write some simple program. So I say print and say welcome to Python. So now let's save it. And for execution, you have this bar. So click on this execute script. So here you can see this welcome to Python output. Now let's go back to this the SQL page. So now let's connect to this connection. So right click on this one and say open connection, and here enter the password. So I connected to my local MySQL database. So where I can see this schema. So the first schema is Sakila, where I can see this tables, and other is Sys schema, and in world I see some tables, city, country, all this. So now let's connect to this schema. So for connecting this world schema, just double click on it. So when it is converted into world, it means that you are connected to this schema. So now in the city, let's say select staff from city. So this is my select statement. Let's select this, and for execution, so just click on this bar, execute the selected portion of the script or everything. So here you can see this the ID, name, the country code, district, and population of the city. Yeah, that's all for this MySQL workbench installation process. Hope this video will help you to install MySQL workbench and give some idea about MySQL workbench functionality. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.